Myself, Mrs. Anju Jodish, your computer teacher. I hope you and your family members are keeping fine. In this video, we will discuss Class 8 Computer, Chapter 1, Operating System and GUI, Role and Functions. GUI means Graphical User Interface. In this module, you will learn about what is an operating system, need for an operating system, functions of operating system, types of operating system, user interface, and types of user interface. Let us discuss about what is computer and its parts. The computer is an electronic device which performs a specific task according to the given instructions. A computer system has two components, hardware and software. Both are equal and important. Children, do you know what is hardware and software? Hardware means the physical parts of a computer that we can see and touch. For example, please look at the picture. What are the hardwares? Mouse, CPU, monitor, keyboard, etc. Software means the instructions that tell the hardware what to do. For example, antivirus, MS Office, different operating systems such as Linux, Unix, Windows. The combinations of hardware and software makes a system. That is, without each other, hardware and software cannot perform any task. Now we will learn about what is software and types of software. Software means the instructions given to the computer in the form of a program is called software. Children, do you know what is a program? Program is a sequence of instructions. It is used to solve a particular problem and make the hardware to perform a specific task. The software can be classified into two ways, depending on the functions and the requirements of a user. These are system software and application software. Examples of system software are Windows, iOS, that is iPhone operating system, Linux, Ubuntu, etc. Adobe Photoshop, MS Word, Adobe Reader, Google Chrome, etc. are the examples of application software. Next, system software. System software instructs a program which interacts with the hardware. It manages the operations of a system. It directs the computer what to do, when to do, and how to do. Functions of system software are reading data, translating data, controlling data, and processing and generating output. System software can be classified as operating system, language processor, device driver, and utility software. As per our syllabus, we have to learn only operating system. Next category of software is application software. It is a set of programs used to perform specific tasks like creating document, presentation, or a database. We can use application software for specific and general purposes. Examples of general software are MS Office, DBMS software, that is database management system software, graphics software, etc. Railway, bank, hospitals, etc. are the examples of specific software. Now, we will discuss about an operating system. Basically, operating system is a set of programs which is used to operate the system, and it acts as a platform for computer hardware and user. It coordinates the activities and sharing the resources of a computer. Every computer must have an operating system to run another program. An operating system encompasses all operations such as what to do, when to do, and how to do. For example, DOS, that is disk operating system, Unix, Linux, Windows, etc. The operating system is an essential component of the system software. Almost everyone is using mobile phones, playing games, or using specific apps. Children, do you know the technique behind online apps and games you use and play? Yes, for using those apps, we need the software. That is, we need an interface which is used to communicate between the user and the devices. Next, need for an operating system, that is importance of an operating system. First, to start or boot the computer. Booting means starts the operating system of a computer when it turned on. Second, to create a link between the hardware resources, the user, and the applications. Third, to manage the files and folders stored in the computer. So, operating system is called resource allocator, deallocator. Fourth, to control and monitor the functioning of the application programs executing on it. Next topic, functions of operating system. An operating system provides a variety of services to your computer and its users. Some of the major functions of an operating system are, first point, program execution. It receives the commands from any application or system program, interprets it, and then executes it. Second point, device management. It controls the working of all the devices connected to your computer. That is, operating system manages all input or output devices such as mouse, keyboard, monitor, printer, etc. Third point, file management. It helps to organize all data in files or folders and allocates space for files on secondary storage devices. It can manipulate, store, retrieve, and save data file on computers. Fourth point, memory management. Children, do you know what is memory? Memory is a major part of the computer system. It manages the main memory, ensuring the efficient functioning of the computer. Next topic, types of operating system. The operating system is classified into the following types depending on their capability of processing. First type, single user operating system. It is used on a single computer for performing a single task. That is, it performs one task at a time. Example, MS-DOS. Second type, multi-user operating system. It allows same data and application to be used by multiple users at the same time. The users can also communicate with each other. Examples are Linux and Unix. Third type, multi-processing operating system. It allows a user to run and work on multiple applications at the same time. Examples are Linux, Unix, and Windows 7. Fourth type, real-time operating system. It is designed to control machines such as guided missiles, nuclear reactor, and online ticket reservation system. It is a multitask. The real-time operating system depends on the time in which the results are produced and on the logical results of the computation. Distributed operating system. It is used on a network as it allows shared data to be accessed from any machine on the network. It controls these interconnected systems and makes them appear on a single computer. Example, locus. 6th, interactive operating system. It provides a GUI, that is graphical user interface, through which the user can easily navigate. Examples are Mac, that is Macintosh operating system, and Windows. Commonly used operating systems. First, Windows. It is a GUI, and various versions of Windows are shown in screen. That is Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 95, Windows 98, Windows 7, etc. Second, Unix. It is a multitasking, multi-user operating system developed in 1969. Third, Linux. It is a free and open source software, which means it is freely available for use. Fourth, Solaris. It is free Unix-based operating system introduced by Sun Microsystems in 1992. Fifth, mobile operating system. It operates on digital mobile devices like smartphone and tablets. It includes Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, mobile navigators, and many more. Examples of mobile operating system are iOS, Android, Windows Phone 7, BlackBerry, etc. Next topic, user interface. Interface is the platform where two systems interact with each other. So, user interface is the platform by which the user and the computer machine exchange information and instructions to complete a task. With the help of interface, user can manipulate and control the hardware and software. Types of user interface. There are two types of user interface, that is CUI and GUI. CUI is character user interface. GUI is graphical user interface. Next, we will discuss about character user interface, that is CUI. CUI allows the user to interact with the computer machine by typing commands through keyboard. Unix and DOS are the CUI based operating systems. CUI is also known as CLI. CLI means command line interface. Children, you know what is the first operating system of Microsoft? Answer is DOS 1.0. It was launched in August 1981. This picture shows example of CUI. Next, graphical user interface, that is GUI. A GUI is the most common type of user interface. It is easiest way to interact with the computers because you can see your options in graphical form. It uses pictures, graphics, and icons. In this, user chooses an option by pointing a mouse at an icon. If you have touch screen computer, you can use touch gestures to interact with the system. Gestures means like tap, press, hold, pinch, scroll, rotate, etc. Linux and Windows are the GUI based operating systems. Windows 1.0 was launched by Microsoft in November 1985. Children, I hope you understood about CUI and GUI. Now, we will discuss about differentiate between CUI and GUI. CUI means Character User Interface. GUI means Graphical User Interface. First difference. A CUI use characters on screen that are controlled with keyboard. But GUI use pictures, graphics, and icon that are controlled with mouse. Second difference, only one application can run at a time. But in GUI, number of applications can be opened and executed in the different windows at the same time. Third difference, the syntax and various options are required to be remembered. In GUI, no need to remember the commands as it is user friendly. Fourth difference, MS-DOS is characterized as CUI, but Windows is characterized as GUI. Children, God bless you. Stay safe. Stay at home.